हेलो चिल्ड्रेन ऑफ क्लास 10, टुडे आई विल टीच द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द लेसन द डायरी ऑफ द यंग गर्ल। आई हैव टॉट इट बिफोर 2 days आई हैव टॉट इट। फर्स्ट डे आई इंट्रोड्यूस्ड अबाउट द टॉपिक, सेकेंड डे आई टॉट यू सम पार्ट ऑफ दिस लेसन। इन दिस लेसन यू हैव फाउंड दैट व्हेन शी वॉज सीटिंग अलोन इन द रूम and thinking whether she would go out or not, finally she decided to write diary. She is telling she had 30 friends, but no one was her true friend whom she could confide, she could share anything. She is telling it was her fault that she did not confide to each other, and because she would not depend upon it, so she decided to write a diary. To enhance the image of this long-awaited friend, in my imagination, I don't want to jot down the facts in this diary the way most people would do. To enhance means to enrich, to flourish the image of this long-awaited friend, the friend for whom she was awaiting for a long time in her imagination. In her imagination, she was waiting for a true friend. And so this she got. She didn't want to write down, jot down means write down, the fact in the diary which the most people do. But I want the diary to be my friend and I am going to call this friend Kitty. She want the diary to be her friend and she was going to call this friend Kitty. Since no one would understand a word of my stories to Kitty if I were to plunge right in, I would better provide a brief sketch of my life, much as I dislike doing so. She is telling that nobody would understand a word of her, the story of to Kitty, what she wrote in the Kitty, if she were in plunge writing. So what did she better think to provide a brief sketch of her life, a short sketch of her life, which she much disliked to do, but she thought she would write. Now she is writing about her life. My father, the most adorable father I have ever seen. Adorable means lovable. For father, she is telling, he was most lovable person. Didn't marry my mother until he was 36 and she was 25. Her father married when he was 36 years old and her mother was 25 years old. My sister Margot was born in Frankfurt in Germany in 1926. Her sister's name was Margot, who was born in Frankfurt in Germany in 1926. I was born on 12 June 1929 and she was born on 12 June 1929. So sister in 1926 and she was in 1929. I lived in Frankfurt until I was 4. She lived in Frankfurt until she was 4 years old. My father emigrated to Holland in 1933. In 1933, her father transferred to Holland. My mother, Edith Hollander Frank, went with him to Holland in September. Her mother's name was Edith Hollander Frank. She also went with him to Holland in September. While Margot and I were sent to Aachen to stay with our grandmother. In that time, she and Margot, both the sisters, were sent to Aachen. Aachen, where their grandmother was living, to stay with their grandmother. Margot went to Holland in December and I followed in February when I was plunked down on the table as a birthday present to Margot. Margot went to Holland in December and she also went in February. She was put on the table in front of Margot like a gift of birthday. She was the gift of birthday for her sister. I started right away at the Montessori Nursery School. She started her schooling in the Montessori Nursery School. I stayed there until I was 6, at which time I started in the first form. When she was 6 years old, she stayed there, and that time she started in class 1. First form means class 1. In the sixth form, in class 6, my teacher was Mrs. Kopras, the headmistress. At the end of the year, we were both in tears as we said a heartbreaking farewell. When she was in class 6, her teacher was Kopras, headmistress. Both were in tears, she and her class teacher. Both were in tears, both were weeping. Why were they both weeping? Because it was the heartbreaking farewell. In the summer of 1941, Grandma fell ill and had to have an operation. So my birthday passed with little celebration. In the summer of 1941, her grandma fell ill, and so she had to have an operation. And for this reason, her birthday was not celebrated in a vast way. It was celebrated in a little way. Grandma died in January 1942. In January 1942, her grandma died. No one knows how often I think of her and still love her. No one knows that she always think of her. She thought of her very much, and she loved her very much after her death also. This birthday celebration in 1942 was intended to make up for the other, and Grandma's candle was the along with the rest. In this birthday, she had to celebrate because of others, and so she also lit a candle for her grandma. With rest candles, she also lit a candle for her grandma. The four of us means father, mother, and both the sisters, Annie and Margot, are still doing well. Their time was going on well. And that brings me to the present date of 20 June 1942. And now it is the date of when she has start present date and the solemn dedication of my diary. And it is the serious dedication of her diary. Now she started writing diary. Dear diary, she started from her classroom, memorization of her school time. Our entire class is quaking in its boots. The reason, of course, is the forthcoming meeting in which the teachers decide who will move up to the next form and who will be kept back. Half the class is making beds. Jean and I laugh ourselves silly at the making at the two boys behind us, Cian and Jax, who have asked their entire holiday saving on their bed from morning to night. It's you are going to pass. No, I am not. Yes, you are. No, I am not. Even G's pleasing glances and my angry outburst can't calm them down. If you ask me, there are so many dummies that about a quarter of the class should be kept back. But teachers are the most unpredictable creatures on earth. She is telling the whole class, entire class means whole class, was shaking in its boots, quaking in its boots. It means whole class was shivering because there was the forthcoming. There was coming a meeting in which teachers would declare the result. Now the students of the class were making bets that somebody was telling Jax. Jean and Annie were laughing and telling that who will pass and who will fail. She is telling in her class there were many dummies, quarter of the class, one fourth of the class, who would be kept back, who should be kept back. But she is telling for the teachers who are unpredictable on the earth, creatures on the earth. Unpredictable means who can't be predicted, about whom it is difficult to say anything. we cannot foretell anything. Such creatures are teachers, according to Annie. I am not so worried about my girlfriends and myself. We will make it. The only subject I am not sure about is maths. Anyway, all we can do is wait. Until then, we keep telling each other not to lose heart. I get along pretty well with all my teachers. There are 9 of them, 7 men and 2 women. Mr. Kissing, the old fogey who teaches maths, was annoyed with me for ages because I talked so much. After several warnings, he assigned me extra homework and essay on the subject. A chatterbox. A chatterbox, what can you write about that? I would worry about that later. I decided I jotted down the title in my notebook, tucked it in my bag and tried to keep quiet. She is telling she and her girlfriend about her girlfriend. She was not so worried because they would be promoted, she thought. Only one subject for what she was not sure, that was math. But only what could they do? They would only wait for the result. And each other they would tell not to lose heart. She was nice with all her teachers. There were 9 teachers, 7 were men and 2 were women. About Mr. Kissy, she is telling he was an old fogey who teaches math. Old fogey means old-fashioned person. Who annoyed me with for ages because I talked so much. Mr. Kissy was annoyed with her because she was a talkative girl. After several warnings, Mr. Kissing gave her several warnings, but she was not improved. She was still talking. Then he assigned him extra homework. That was an essay on the subject, a chatterbox. Chatterbox means very talkative person. And gave her to write about it. About that, she was worried. She decided. She wrote down the title in her notebook, kept it in the bag, and tried to maintain silence. That evening, after I had finished the rest of my homework, the note about the essay caught my eye. That evening, when she finished her homework, the note about the essay, her eyes went to the note about the essay. She started looking on the note which was given to write an essay. I began thinking about the subject while chewing the tip of my fountain pen. She was chewing the tip. Tip means the nib of the fountain pen. And thinking what to write. Anyone could ramble on and leave big space between the words. But the trick was to come up with the convincing arguments to provide the necessity of talking. She is telling anyone could write by leaving big spaces between the words. But here her decision was to write the topic in such a way so that her arguments would convince the teacher. It was needed of her talking. I thought, and suddenly I had an idea. She thought, and suddenly she got an idea. I wrote the 3 pages Mr. Kissing had assigned me and was satisfied. She wrote 3 pages in the diary Mr. Kissing assigned him, and she was satisfied. He was satisfied. I argued that talking is a student's trait and that I would do my best to keep it under control. She wrote that talking is the habit of a student and she would try her best to keep it under control. Thanks.